Welcome back to a second example of determining the point of intersection of two linear functions. In the first example, we solved it graphically and algebraically, but looking at these two linear functions, because this y-intercept is a fraction, it'd be much more difficult to graph this accurately. So we'll go ahead and solve this algebraically and then verify it graphically since I've graphed it using some graphing software. To determine the point of intersection of these two linear functions, we want to determine when f of x is equal to g of x. Well, this will occur when 1/2 x plus 7/10 is equal to 4/5 x minus 2. So we'll set this up as an equation and solve for x, which will give us the x coordinate of the point of intersection, and then we'll use one of the functions to determine the corresponding y coordinate. So we first need to solve the equation 1/2 x plus 7/10 is equal to 4/5 x minus 2. The first thing we probably notice is there are fractions in this equation, so it's often recommended to clear the fractions from the equation by multiplying everything by what would be the least common denominator, which would be the least common multiple of 2, 10, and 5, which would be 20, so we're going to multiply both sides of the equation by 20. So we'd have 20 times 1/2 x, which I'll write as 20 over 1 times 1/2 x plus 20 over 1 times 7/10 must equal 20 over 1 times 4/5 x minus 20 times 2. Now we'll go ahead and simplify, which should eliminate all of the fractions. The 2 simplifies to a 1, the 20 simplifies to 10. So here we have 10x. Here the 10 simplifies to 1, the 20 simplifies to 2. So we have plus 14. Here the 5 simplifies to 1, and the 20 simplifies to 4. This will be 16x. And then here we have minus 40. So now we need to solve this equation for x. So we'll start by subtracting 16x on both sides of the equation. This will give us negative 6x plus 14 equals, this would be 0, and then we have negative 40. So now we'll subtract 14 on both sides. This would be 0, so we have negative 6x equals negative 54. Divide both sides by negative 6. And we have x equals 9. So this would be the x coordinate of the point of intersection. In order to determine the corresponding y coordinate, we need to evaluate one of the original functions when x equals 9. It doesn't matter which function we use, let's go ahead and just use f of x. So f of 9 will be equal to 1/2 times 9, which I'll write as 9 over 1, plus 7/10. So we have 9/2 plus 7/10. The common denominator here is going to be 10, so we'll multiply this first fraction by 5 over 5. Now we have a common denominator of 10, and the numerator will be 45 plus 7. Which is equal to 52. This simplifies. They both have a common factor of 2. So this will be 26/5, or if we want 5 1/5. Let's go ahead and leave it as 26/5. Which means our point of intersection, or this point here, has an x-coordinate of 9, and a y-coordinate of 26/5, or 5 1/5. And the graph does verify our work. Notice how the x-coordinate is positive 9, and the corresponding y-coordinate does appear to be a little bit more than 5, or in this case, 5 1/5. So you can see if we just tried to solve this graphically, it would have been very difficult to determine the y-coordinate of this point of intersection.